Hey guys, so I'm Akshansh and I'm gonna show you today how you can create your first Kaggle notebook and use your Gemini API key in it. So most probably you are here from this amazing course by Google in collaboration with Kaggle. If you haven't registered for it, you can register. It will be running from Monday 10th of November to Friday 14th of November for the year 2025. And as you can see, there's a little countdown there. So I'm already registered for it. You can do the same. Or you can just download their Discord, join their Discord server and do the same. Yeah, so amazing course. Now, first, I hope you have your Gemini API key with you. I've posted a video on that. You can just watch it and follow the steps. The steps are demonstrated for both mobile and laptop users, and I'll be doing the same in this tutorial also. You can just follow the timer and skip to the section you want to watch. So yeah, let's get started. So first, go to kaggle.com. I hope you have created your account here. Yeah, I have my account created, and click on create button here, or if you know navbar is closed, just click here and notebook. Now I'll be providing all the links in my description box, so yeah, just know that. Okay, so yep, our notebook is created. Okay, amazing job. You can change your notebook's name. I'll name it test desktop because I'm testing this phone laptop first. Okay, so now I'll be telling you how to use your API here. So this is some by default generated code. What you can do is just delete this code block, just backspace, this CTRL plus A and backspace, right? So yeah, amazing job. And you can now tap on add-ons, right? There's add-ons here, and then click on secrets. Now don't enter your API key just like this, like API key. It won't take a certain minute. For even if your notebook is private, it can easily be hacked by Russian hackers and or any group of individuals, and they won't take a certain minute or second before exploiting your API, crossing the rate limits, crossing your balance, and just giving you dollars of bills, right? Any currency, right? Rupees, foreigners, any currency. They won't give a damn about you. They'll just exploit it, they'll use it for themselves, and yeah, they'll just spam. Don't do this. Go to add-ons. So I told you the vulnerabilities of doing this. So yeah, now add-ons, secrets. You'll see this add secret button right here, add secret, and you can name it anything. I'll be naming it Gemini underscore API key, and now enter the value CTRL plus V, right? You must have copied this from your Google Gemini dashboard, right? Like you can just go to aistudio.google.com. And this is for the mobile user. Let me just switch. Yeah, you can just go to your get API key and you can copy it from a test API key, and you can go back to your Kaggle account. Now add this API key right here and save. So as you can see, I already had an API key for my old project. So once you save some secret, it will be available in all your notebooks, all your private public notebooks. So, and it's really safe. It's really safe. Yeah. So now just copy this code to clipboard, right? And you can close this or just let it be like this. And CTRL plus V here, right? Now this is the code they will be using to get this whatever API key you have named it. Yeah, so I have named it Gemini API key, so it's Gemini API key. If I had named it Google API key, it would be Google API key, right? So they'll basically search for this name from here, and if the name is invalid, for example, if you do I, this probably doesn't exist, so they'll just throw an error. Let's see, it should be like that. They should throw an error, right? It's taking a lot of time, I don't know why. Draft session is starting. You can see the progress here. It's starting. Let's just wait for a while. Yeah, so we have an error. There appears to be no secret named. Would you like to add one? So, no. You can just do CTRL plus Z. And you don't have to do this. I just wanted to demonstrate this to you. So yeah, now Shift plus Enter is what you can do, or you can just press the Run button here. Now, okay. So I just ran this with Shift plus Enter, and let's try printing it. Right. Let's try print secret. So yeah. Also, I'll be deleting these API keys. That's why I'm able to show them to you so openly, but you don't have to share these. You'll get a big bill on your account if they are a bad group of people or bad individual. So yeah, print, and here we have our API key. So you can use it in your code however you want, however you wish to. So yeah, amazing thing, amazing job. And yep, now let's start the same process for our fellow mobile users. Oh, let me just go to the home page. Homepage, and let me just switch to my mobile interface. Inspect. There we go. Right. So now what you have to do is, for mobile users, you have to click on this hamburger icon. It's called hamburger icon. You have to click it here, and you can put click on this create button. You have to you can either import or create a notebook, and wait for a while. It's taking quite a time. Yeah, so now let's just change the name for now. Let's call it our test mobile notebook or whatever you want. So it's taking a little bit time to load, right? What we can do till then, we can just go to our Gemini and we can bring our API key. So you can just copy Gemini test mobile or whatever you have. I'll just delete this old one, right? We don't need it now. You can just delete it like this, three dot. Okay, yeah, so one more thing. Now let's just go to CTRL plus 3. Let's go to our site. Delete this code block. Don't delete it, right? You cannot delete it. One code block is must, right? So CTRL plus A, for mobile users you cannot do this, right? So what you have to do is, you gotta move right here and press that delete button on your keyboard. Mobile users don't have that option. Or I'll show you a simpler step. You can just click on this plus code button, and now you can delete this code cell, right? It will be much easier for you. You don't have that select all CTRL plus A button, right? So yep. Now what we have to do, we have to add our API key right here. So you can just click on this hamburger icon again. And add-ons, secrets. Now add secret, and here Gemini_API_key_M. It's for mobile, right? And just name it as something unique, right? And just save it. And as you can see, I have these APIs from my past project, right? So you can just copy this to your clipboard, this code, like how I can use this API key. And now you can just, and yeah, if you want to import multiple keys, you can just select on this tick icon and it will just show the same code for that secret. And also, now we have copied this, let's just close this and CTRL plus V. And now you can see this API key is here, and as I demonstrated for laptop users, you'll get the same error if you just use I or something else. For example, if you just use some name that is the API key associated with them is not there, right? We don't have any API keys named I, as I can demonstrate to you. We don't have any API keys with I, so we'll be getting a little error. I'll just demonstrate to you. Let's just wait. It takes a little bit of time. You can see the progress here, like it's saying starting dot 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 dot. See the progress being made here. And yep, as you can see, we have our error, our little error, and you can attach your API key. We already have it. So yeah, you don't have to follow this step. It was just for demonstration. Great, great job. Now you can just run this code block. You don't have to shift plus enter, right? You'll have to tap on this plus icon. And amazing, amazing job. Now we can just print our API key. Secret underscore value underscore zero, and yeah, this icon, and here we have our API key. Yay, let's go. Amazing job. Now whenever you want to access it, you can do it like this. Amazing job. And now I can just delete it, I don't need it anymore. And if you also don't need this API key once in a, like, you someday you don't just need it, so you can just go here. First let me just open the mobile interface. Yeah, so you can come here to this website, sorry, you can come here, you can go to nav bar, you can get API key, and you will be redirected to this page, and you can just delete it. Okay, you can just delete it. Yeah, so amazing job with this tutorial. So that is it. You have now learned how to add your API key into your Kaggle account and how to add it inside your, use it in your Collab notebook or Kaggle notebook. Collab is for Google Collab. That's a different type of Jupyter notebooks. Yeah, that's a different service, just like Kaggle. So yeah, that's pretty much it. See you in the next one.